Director, Vivekananda International Foundation. His Excellency, Foreign Secretary of Sri Lanka, is with us. Dr. Sri Radha Datta, Center Head and Senior Fellow, Neighborhood Studies, VIF. Distinguished panelists, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. First, I must apologize for joining a little late because of some technical difficulties, but I'm absolutely delighted to participate in this event to release the book, which we just released, edited by Sri Radha Datta, entitled BIMSTEC, The Journey and Way Forward. May I take this opportunity to congratulate both VIF and the editor and all the distinguished authors who have contributed various chapters to this book. I'm also very pleased to see that the book is a collaborative effort of authors spread across the BIMSTEC countries. It thus brings a range of ideas and perspectives that truly represent the BIMSTEC spirit. The book is a very well-researched book, and I have no doubt that it will contribute to a better understanding of BIMSTEC and the challenges, opportunities, and way forward for deeper, wider, and greater BIMSTEC cooperation for a peaceful, prosperous, and sustainable Bay of Bengal region. The postscript of the book, written by Dr. Datta and Chavi Vashisht, makes some useful policy recommendations. I think that the book is the first of its kind, marking the 25 years of BIMSTEC. Indeed, it is a commendable achievement by all of its distinguished authors, the editor and VIF. A major pillar of BIMSTEC cooperation is to promote and expand scope of people-to-people contacts in the region. Vivekananda International Foundation has been making a very useful contribution in this regard. It successfully hosted two BIMSTEC Track 2 security dialogues in 2018 and 2019 to complement the formal mechanism led by the National Security Advisors. We greatly appreciate these initiatives by VIF. I am delighted that we are joined today by His Excellency Admiral Jayant Kolumbage, Foreign Secretary of Sri Lanka. He is also one of the co-authors of the book, contributing a chapter titled BIMSTEC Post-COVID-19 International Regional Order and the Journey and the Way Ahead, Sri Lankan Perspective. His participation is today very important, as Sri Lanka is also the current chair of BIMSTEC. Excellencies, friends, BIMSTEC enjoys the unique strength of connecting South and Southeast Asia. The holding of BIMSTEC Outreach Summit and Leaders Retreat in Goa in October 16, an invitation extended to BIMSTEC leaders by a Prime Minister at the government swearing-in ceremony in May 2019, reflect the growing importance of BIMSTEC in India's foreign policy. Regional cooperation under BIMSTEC complements India's neighborhood first and Act East policies and has a special significance for the development of our Northeast region. For a long time, BIMSTEC process was marked by a high degree of informality without any structured institutions. BIMSTEC received a major thrust at the BIMSTEC Outreach Summit and Leaders Retreat in Goa in October 2016, in which the leaders agreed to work collectively to make the organization stronger, more effective, and result-oriented. Various initiatives in the key areas of security and counterterrorism, connectivity and trade, environment and disaster management, energy and people-to-people contacts were focused upon, providing much greater visibility to BIMSTEC and its initiatives. In keeping with the renewed focus, India organized several activities in 2017 and 2018 to advance the agenda for action adopted by the leaders' retreat in Goa, which included holding the first meeting of NS National Security Chiefs of BIMSTEC countries, first meeting of BIMSTEC network of tour operators, first annual disaster management exercise, among many others. Given the increased emphasis on BIMSTEC cooperation, a number of events were also organized by India to mark the 20th anniversary of BIMSTEC in 2017-18. The fourth BIMSTEC summit in Kathmandu built on this momentum and provided the future roadmap to intensify regional cooperation in diverse sectors in a result-oriented manner. It also gave direction to BIMSTEC to formalize its internal structures and processes and set the platform for high-level engagements at regular intervals. The direction given to BIMSTEC Secretariat to prepare a charter for the organization built on the 1997 Bangkok Declaration has since resulted in the finalization of the charter, which will be adopted at the next summit. The last summit also decided to establish a BIMSTEC permanent working committee to expedite implementation of decisions taken at the summit and ministerial levels. This committee has been constituted and has already had 4 meetings since then. In the last 3 years, the committee has negotiated several agreements to enhance regional cooperation and also paved the way for it to build institutional capacity. These include the BIMSTEC Charter, the BIMSTEC Convention on Mutual Legal Assistance in Criminal Matters, MOU on Cooperation between Diplomatic Academies of BIMSTEC Countries, Memorandum of Association on the Establishment of BIMSTEC Technology Transfer Facility in Colombo, amongst many other. BIMSTEC, meanwhile, as announced by India and Kathmandu, several events involving BIMSTEC member countries was organized by India, such as these BIMSTEC Startup Conclave, BIMSTEC Military Exercise, Second BIMSTEC Disaster Management Exercise, etc. Friends, 2 important areas of BIMSTEC cooperation that have received significant prominence in the last few years are connectivity and security sector cooperation. Development and prosperity go hand in hand with peace and security. We face both traditional and non-traditional security challenges. Cooperation in the security sector, therefore, has a special significance for us. Our NSAs have met thrice since 2017. They have been working closely and have moved forward in several aspects of security cooperation, including counterterrorism, intelligence sharing, anti-money laundering, combating the financialism, countering radicalization, legal and law enforcement issues, drugs and human trafficking, coastal security, cyber security, etc. I'm glad to note that the BIMSTEC Convention on Cooperation in Combating International Terrorism, Transnational Organized Crime, and Illicit Drug Trafficking has come into force earlier this year. The convention will provide a robust legal basis to further strengthen our cooperation in this area. Progress has also been made on several other initiatives that emerged from the NSA level dialogues. Friends, the robust transport connectivity is an essential prerequisite for economic integration of the region. We are very pleased that the BIMSTEC Transport Connectivity Master Plan has been finalized and endorsed by the foreign ministers for adoption at the next summit. In anticipation of its adoption, the ADB has conducted the first consultative workshop on financing of the Transport Connectivity Master Plan earlier this month. The member states have also made progress on finalizing the BIMSTEC Coastal Shipping Agreement, now proposed to be renamed as BIMSTEC Maritime Transport Cooperation Agreement. The second working group meeting to discuss the agreement is proposed to be held virtually next month. There is a steady progress being made in other areas of BIMSTEC cooperation in the fields of culture, agriculture, trade. The way forward in the forthcoming BIMSTEC summit will take several important decisions that will establish BIMSTEC as a full-fledged regional intergovernmental organization. The next year will mark the silver jubilee of the establishment of BIMSTEC, as mentioned by our External Affairs Minister in a statement at the 17th ministerial meeting, which I think Dr. Arvind Gupta also quoted. He said that it is high time that we collectively dwell upon ways to make a paradigm shift in rising the level of BIMSTEC cooperation and regional integration. A book by VIF is very timely effort in this regard. I'm confident that the book will be an excellent read and useful resource for diplomats, policymakers, researchers, and scholars of the region and beyond who are interested in our regional cooperation. I once again thank VIF for taking the initiative for putting together such a book, which was really required, and for this event to launch the book. And I'm very thankful once again to the Foreign Secretary of Sri Lanka for joining us today. Thank you all.